first shows ever playing in Brooklyn was here. So like, well, once we got here, I was like, oh, I remember this place. So a lot of people I used to know from Montreal moved to LA. So I was like, I'll go to LA, I guess. Although it's a great city. For me, my home is just where my crew is. Well, we auditioned 250 girls, actually, for the dancers. And then we were like, okay, who are the weirdest girls? And we just kind of picked out the most sort of eccentric dancers, and because they do a lot of improv and stuff too, so that's really important. It's a very superstitious situation, but basically, I don't know how to describe this, it sounds so weird. But like, okay, so like if you're like good to your art angels, if you know, don't worry about too much about how a song's gonna be played live, you just make a song, then like they're good to you and you get good songs. But like, you know, if you like abuse them, if you're like, time for the pop single, they're like, no, then you don't get good songs. So it's like, you know, the voices of inspiration, it's like the less you push them, the like better the music is. And for me, it's always been this weird balance of like trying to work with like whatever the voice of inspiration is. And so it seemed like an apt title for the album, because I've been referring to them as the art angels to my friends over the last few years. So that just seemed like an apt title. Like, I'm really into my friends and I, you know, I let them tattoo me and I tattoo them. Magical Clouds, Blood Diamonds gave me that one. This one I just let a random guy do. And this one, I can't tell if it's Homer Simpson or a ghost. Either way, I'm down. Hey, I'm Grimes, you're watching Steve Madden Music.